Hello, welcome. There were some questions in my mind as to why does some of us learn things more easily than others? Why some of us tend to forget things that we learn? Is there any way of recovery or reorganization from damage of brain cells after a stroke? For obvious reasons, I was looking for the answers of these questions that fascinated me to carry out an analysis on the ideas and thoughts on brain of various brain researchers, and obviously followed by my thoughts on their relevance to the concepts. If you see my whole video, I can assure you all you will definitely enter into the fascinating domain as to how you can build a brain. And you will not remain the same after watching my video. You'll be amazed at how much unrealized potential you have and how magnificent your brain is. The reality is that no one is any smarter or cleverer than anyone else. The difference lies in understanding as to how to unlock your brain power and potential. And you can make your brain smarter every day and at any age. We all know that our brain is made up of approximately 100 billion neurons. To give you an idea of its size, if every brain cells or neurons was to echo 1 second, then the number of neurons you will have would echo more than 3,100 years. Again, our brain capacity is of 2.5 petabytes, which is equivalent to approximately 2,560 computers if the configuration of a computer is of 1 terabyte each. So, this massive amount of brain capacity and neurons gives everyone the opportunity to achieve extraordinary things. The trick is understanding how the brain works so that you could leverage this power to ensure that everybody lives up to their true potential. Everything that you do stems from your brain cells or neurons forming connections with each other. So if you want, you can definitely harness the inbuilt power you have and can excel. It's amazing to know the fact that our brain is changing at a breathtaking pace. And perhaps the most exciting, the most interesting and transformative of the discovery is that every time you learn a new fact or skill, you change your brain. It's something the doctor calls neuroplasticity. And this neuroplasticity gives you the power to shape the brain you want. I have learned that our brain changes in 3 very basic ways to support learning. The first is chemical. So brain actually functions by transferring chemical signals between brain cells, what we call neurons. And this triggers series of actions and reactions. The second way the brain can change to support learning is by altering its structure. Here the physical structure of the brain is actually changing. Now the last way the brain can change to support learning is by altering its functions. So with learning we see that the whole network of the brain activity is shifting and changing. So neuroplasticity is supported by chemical, by structure and by functional changes. And these are happening across the whole brain. They can occur in isolation, but most often they take place in concert. Together they support learning and they're taking place all the time. Structural changes also can lead to integrated networks of brain regions that functions together to support learning. It can also lead to certain brain regions that are important for very specific behaviors to change your structure or to enlarge. One thing is absolutely clear, the best driver of neuroplasticity change in our brain is our behavior. So we must practice behavior. Nothing is more effective than practice, and we can prepare our brain to learn. I have also learned that the loss of brain cells with aging results in damage like a stroke. And then studies begin to show remarkable amounts of reorganization in the adult brain. And the ensuing research has shown that all of our behaviors change our brain. And these changes are not limited by age. Good news. And in fact, they're taking place all the time. And very importantly, brain reorganization helps to support recovery after a damaged brain. Now let's see a short video clip by brain researcher, Professor Dr. Lara Boy.
One thing is absolutely clear. The best driver of neuroplastic change in your brain is your behavior. So the first lesson is that the primary driver of change in your brain is your behavior. So there's no neuroplasticity drug you can take. Nothing is more effective than practice at helping you learn. And the bottom line is, you have to do the work. And in fact, my research has shown that increased difficulty, increased struggle, if you will, during practice, actually leads to both more learning and greater structural change in the brain. The problem here is that neuroplasticity can work both ways. It can be positive. You learn something new, and you refined a motor skill. It also can be negative, though. You forgot something you once knew. You become addicted to drugs. Maybe you have chronic pain. So your brain is tremendously plastic, and it's being shaped both structurally and functionally by everything you do, but also by everything that you don't do.
So you need to study as to why and how you learn best. You have to keep those behaviors that are healthy for your brain and break those habits which are not. Increase difficulty, increase struggle if you practice, you learn more and greater structural changes take place in your brain. So everything you do, you encounter, you learn, everything you experience is changing your brain. So each of us is going to have changed our brain differently. Understanding the differences, individual patterns, the variability and change is going to enable and unlock the potential you have. So bottom line is you have to do the work and brainstorming exercises that will help you learn. Contrary to what we thought, the brain doesn't stop changing or developing at a certain age. The brain constantly changes its shape and chemical processes and patterns regularly. And these changes are determined mainly by our individual behaviors. So if we choose to change our brains, we must change our actions, like what we do, where we go to, what we listen to, what we see around us, etc. There is no quick fix or drug to enhance neuroplasticity than to change your behavior. It is interesting to note that the overlapping discovery, which can be generalized that our behavior is the major and lasting way to change our brain. You want a better brain? Choose to behave better. Try to do something new. Consciously decide to get more knowledge on anything. Meet new people. Try new methods and change your environment. These new actions help you absorb new facts which go on shaping your brain. Find out what's unique about you. Find what works for you, find the pattern that suits you most for learning, and change your behavior as required to put your brain to best use. So prepare, develop and build your brain, which you can undoubtedly do it by yourself if you want to. Here I have come to the end. My next video will be on life lessons from Sharuk's speech at Edinburgh University, where he was awarded with a doctorate. Thanks for watching.